गुड मॉर्निंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दी चैप्टर नंबर 2 फ्रॉम पेपर सेकंड, दैट इज ट्रांजिस्टर्स। ऑलरेडी हाफ चैप्टर वी आर कम्प्लीटेड नाउ, सो अगेन वी स्टार्ट आउट दैट चैप्टर फ्रॉम द ट्रांजिस्टर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कर्व्स। ओके, सो इन ट्रांजिस्टर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कर्व्स वी आर गोइंग टू ऑब्जर्व द बिहेवियर बिटवीन द करंट एंड वोल्टेजेस ऑफ द ट्रांजिस्टर। सो फॉर दैट पर्पज यू हैव टू अरेंज द सर्किट। This is the NPN transistor which is connected in a common emitter configuration. So here RC and this resistor RB is connected in the circuit. So the RC provides load to the transistor and RB limits the current for the transistor. Okay, so we are going to observe here the variation between the current and voltages of a transistor. So in this case, so we apply a base to emitter voltage so that it forward biases base to emitter junction, and VCC is the voltage applied to the collector so that because of the high voltage VCC, it reverse biases the base to collector junction. Okay, so to observe the characteristic curves, so just we are going to vary the voltage VCC from 0 to maximum and observe the variation between or relation between collector current and the collector to emitter voltage. This is a simple thing, so that you have to vary the VCC voltage so that you can change the collector to emitter voltage from 0 to maximum. Okay, so on x axis we are going to vary the VCE and we are going to observe the collector current through the transistor. Okay, and whatever the relation between collector current and the VCE, collector to emitter voltage, gives the characteristic curves for different values of input current, that is base current. Okay, so for a different values of base current IB, you are going to check the relation or variation between collector current and the VC. So if we observe for VBB equal to 0 volt, if we apply 0 volt, then IB is equal to 0 also. Okay, so in that case, when base voltage is 0, the NPN transistor is in off state. You very well know that as the NPN transistor or any transistor is in off state, okay, when the transistor is in off state, there is no current flowing through it. Okay, that means collector current is 0. So collector current is 0 because IB is 0, and this is the voltage VCE. Let us see what happened about the VC. So consider that base voltage VB is 0, so therefore there is no forward bias between base to emitter junction and IB is equal to 0. Then now we are going to observe the variation between collector current IC and VCE for IB equal to 0 ampere. Okay, so as this is 0, the transistor is in off state. As this transistor is in off state, collector current is 0. But if you observe here base to collector junction of this transistor, so collector voltage it has higher potential and this base is at the lower potential. Okay, so because of this, collector is n-type. So this base to collector junction is reverse bias. So because of this reverse bias, there is a reverse leakage current flowing through the junction. Okay, so base to collector is reverse bias, so there is very leakage current flows through it. So as we increase the voltage from 0 to maximum, there is a reverse leakage current and it is nearly constant. Okay, so this collector current is negligible and practically considered as a zero. So theoretically we can see there is a reverse leakage current, but practically this leakage current is nearly zero. So this region where the transistor acts like off, so it is in off state. So this region is known as cutoff region. Okay, so this region is known as cutoff region. So in this region, the base to emitter junction is reverse biased, and base to collector junction is also reverse biased. Why base to emitter junction is reverse biased? Because base voltage is 0 volt. So in this region, base to emitter junction is reverse biased, and also base to collector junction is reverse biased. So this is RR state. Okay, so this is RR state of the transistor biasing, in which it acts like a off, or it is an off state. This region is known as cutoff. As we increase the base voltage, small current flows through the base to emitter junction and IB increases. Okay, suppose IB is increased up to 10 microampere. As example, IB is increased up to 10 microampere because of increase in a VBB. Now we vary the voltage VC from 0 to some maximum value and observe the collector current. Okay, by increasing the VCC, we can vary the voltage VCE and observe the collector current. In this case, initially current increases, and after that there is a very slow increase in a collector current for IB equal to 10 microampere. Similarly, if we increase the base voltage and it increases the base current up to say 20 microampere, in that case also, if we increase the VCC voltage from 0 to maximum, so current increases, and after that there is a slowly increase in a current for IB equal to 20 microampere. So similarly, as we increase the base voltage, we get the same characteristic curves, but the magnitude or the voltage or current is little bit increased. Okay, so here collector current a little bit increased with increase in IV. So this is nothing but the characteristic curves of a transistor. Okay, so there is only current magnitude increases, we get the same characteristic curve, only magnitude is increased. Okay, so this is the transistor characteristic curve. If we observe this area, in this area the base voltage is something high, which forward biases base to emitter junction. Okay, so here this in this area, if you consider this one, IB is something 30 microampere, so that the base to emitter junction becomes forward biased. Okay, so as base to emitter junction forward biased, and what is about this collector voltage? So collector voltage, if you observe here, collector voltage is also low as compared to base voltage. This collector voltage is low, and also this emitter voltage is low, because there is very small collector voltage VCC is applied. So that's why base to collector junction also becomes forward biased, because this voltage is less than the base voltage. Okay, so at this portion, this VCC is less than the base voltage, so that's why this PN junction gets forward biased. If you observe this region, so in this region, base to emitter junction is a forward bias, and base to collector junction is also forward bias. Okay, so this base to emitter junction is forward bias because of some base voltage is applied, so it get forward bias. So here base to collector junction is also forward bias because this voltage is less than the VBB in this portion. So this region is known as a saturation region. Saturation region, in which both base to emitter and base to collector, both the junctions are in forward bias. So already we seen this, the both the junctions are forward bias, then it is known as FF condition. So in this FF condition, base to emitter junction is forward bias and base to collector junction is also forward bias. So if you consider this region, if we increase the VCC, so because of increase in a VCC, so this PN junction, base to collector junction, gets reverse bias because N is at higher potential and P is at lower potential. So we know that the PN junction gets forward biased when P voltage is greater than N voltage. Okay, if P voltage is less than N voltage, means anode, so this is P, P type is anode and N type is a cathode. If P voltage is less than N voltage, then it gets reverse biased. Okay, it gets forward biased when P is higher than N. Similarly, if we observe here, this N is at higher potential and P is at lower potential. Okay, so it gets reverse biased. So base to collector junction becomes reverse biased and base to emitter junction becomes forward biased because of positive potential applied on the base. So in this region, so this is the region where the base to emitter junction is forward biased and base to collector junction is reverse biased. Okay, and this region is known as active region. Okay, so this region is known as active region and it is known as FR condition. Okay, so this total characteristic is divided in three different regions, where first one is a saturation region. The transistor acts like a fully on state. Okay, because there is sharp increase in a collector current with a small increase in a base voltage, so it is known as a saturation region. Okay, so here both base to emitter junction and base to collector junction both are in forward bias, so it is FF condition. So here when base voltage is zero, that is IB current is 0 ampere, so in that case both the junctions are reverse biased, so it is known as RR condition, and this region is known as cutoff region. So this is very small region. Okay, so practically we cannot observe this region, but theoretically we consider this region as a cutoff region. So where the transistor is in off state and the collector current, if you observe this collector current, so this collector current is nearly zero. So this current is known as reverse leakage current. So this is because of reverse leakage current, but actually this current is zero. Okay, so this collector current theoretically shown here, which is reverse leakage current, it is equal to zero, so it is also called as reverse leakage current. Okay, so this current is also reverse leakage current, so I am giving a name, reverse leakage current. Okay, so this, in this region, base to emitter and base to collector junction, so base to emitter is forward biased and base to collector is in reverse bias because of the high VCC voltage. So this known is, this is called as FR condition and this is known as active region. Okay, so this is the active region. So these are the characteristic curves. So here transistor acts off state. So here it is in saturation state, here it is in active state. So here transistor is off state, so therefore collector current is zero. Here is in saturation, collector current is high. Okay, here acts like a closed switch, here acts like an open switch. And in this region, this is called as active region, which is useful for amplification purpose. Okay, so whatever the transistor should be operate in this active region when it is used as an amplifier. Okay, so So this is the transistor characteristic curves. Okay, now we are going to consider the DC load line concept. When the transistor is used as an amplifier, so you have to operate a transistor in a proper way. That means base to emitter junction is forward bias and base to collector junction is in a reverse bias. So that means the transistor should operate in an active region. For the maximum amplification, we get the transistor should operate in the active region with the base to emitter junction forward bias and base to collector junction reverse bias. Okay. So to observe that, we are going to draw a DC load line over which the transistor should operate at that position. Okay. So this is a characteristic curve. So this is the load line which is drawn on a characteristic curve which indicates the operating points of a transistor in a amplifier circuit. Okay, so this is a line which is known as a DC load line which is drawn on the characteristic curves. So this is known as DC load line which is drawn on the characteristic curve which shows the transistor operating points. Okay, that means transistor should operate on this DC load line. It should be here, that means here or here. So we are going to find out the coordinates of the DC load line. So how we are going to draw? So to draw any line, we require two points. So that's why these are two points we should consider at the two extreme conditions. Okay, so for that purpose, you consider this circuit again. Okay, to draw the DC load line, you consider the same circuit. Okay, so it is in common emitter configuration mode. So here we are going to apply AC voltage which should be amplified and you will get the output. Okay, so to operate this transistor, we require a DC voltage which forward biases base to emitter junction. Okay, so which forward biases base to emitter junction. So this is RB. So this is a collector current RC. So this AC is amplified and you are going to observe at this output voltage. So it is a plus VCC. So to find out the coordinates of these two points, you have to consider two extreme condition of the transistor. To find out the coordinates of these two points, consider first the transistor is extremely operated in a saturation. Okay, it is operated in a saturation. Now consider this loop. Okay, you have to consider this circuit from this point to this point. Okay, so there is a voltage drop across the RC. Okay, so we named it as VRC, and there is also voltage drop that is known as VCE across the transistor. If you observe this circuit, total VCC voltage equal to voltage across RC plus voltage across the transistor. So therefore, plus VCC equal to VRC plus voltage across the transistor. Okay, so this VRC is nothing but the current flowing through the resistor into RC. So therefore VCC equal to IC into RC plus VCE. Okay, so you should know this equation which is known as output equation for this circuit. So this is output circuit and this is the input. Input is applied in this circuit. So this is known as input circuit. And output is observed here, so it is called as output circuit. Okay, so consider when the transistor is operated at this point, what happens? Okay, if we consider this condition, when it is in saturation, saturation means this point, consider this A point. Okay, when transistor is operated at A point, in that case, what is about VCE? So this VCE voltage is 0 volt. Okay, from the graph we easily observe that when the transistor is operated at this point, collector current is maximum, and what is about VCE? VCE is the 0. So at the VCE 0 you get the IC maximum. So if we observe when saturation, when transistor operates in a saturation, then VC equal to 0. Okay, when transistor will turn on, current flows through the transistor, IC increases and this collector voltage drops. So VCE equal to 0 volt. If you use here, then we get VCC equal to IC into RC. So therefore IC equal to VCC by RC. So this is nothing but if you observe IC, VC equal to 0, you here in this equation you get IC equal to VCC by RC. You have to use this here. So this is nothing but a coordinates. So x coordinate is VC equal to 0 and y coordinate is IC equal to VCC by RC. So therefore in saturation, here the coordinate of A is given by x coordinates is 0 comma VCC by RC. Okay, so this is a coordinate when transistor operates in a saturation. Now consider the another extreme condition, that is when transistor operates in a cutoff. Okay, when transistor operates in a cutoff means at this point, consider this is a B point, and when transistor operates in a cutoff, that means collector current is 0. We know that when transistor operates in a cutoff, here collector current is 0. So if you use this collector current IC equal to 0, we know that when transistor is off means the current flowing through the transistor is 0. So IC equal to 0 ampere at this position. If you consider the coordinate of this, the IC is 0. And if we use IC 0 in this equation, we get VCC equal to VCE. Okay, if IC is 0, we get VCC equal to VCE. When the transistor is at operated in cutoff, that is at point B, we get a coordinate of B is given by V coordinate. So VC equal to VCC. So VCC comma 0 ampere. So this is the coordinate of this point. If we get the coordinate from this, from given circuit, we can find out the coordinates. So this A coordinate is, okay, so 0 comma VCC by RC is the coordinate of point A, and at point B the coordinate is given by VCC comma 0. So from the given equation, just you can find these two points and draw the line, and you get a DC load line. Okay, so this is nothing but a DC load line. So this DC load line is the most important concept, because when transistor operate as a amplifier, so this transistor operating point or transistor should operate on this line only. So that may be operate here, 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 or here. But main thing you have to consider, when transistor is used as amplifier, it is operated in a active region. That base to emitter junction is forward bias. So this keep in mind, this is most important point. When transistor is used as a amplifier, then it is a FR.